15 years ago, there was a war. Well, war's broken out here plenty of times before. They've tried to invade the Southlands through the Northern Valley time and time again. Luck was never on their side, though, and their victories didn't last long. They didn't realize that times had changed. Facing one defeat after another, losing territory and watching their nation dwindle, they built up their industrial strength to unprecedented heights and used it to wage one final battle against the world. That was 15 years ago. They fought ferociously, but were utterly defeated. The Belkans then committed the unthinkable. They used nuclear weapons on their own soil. Seeing this tragedy unfold before their own eyes, the victorious countries vowed to throw down their weapons. The world was once again at peace. And thanks to them, it seemed it would last forever. On a distant island, far away from civilization, the protectors of the peace take to the skies. Red alert! I was in the sky, trying to get the training team and my viewfinder in the rear seat of the lead plane. My pilot in the front seat was howling at the earth below.
Give me a break. I'm babysitting Nuggets up here.
Command room to War Dog Squadron. We have leakers, aircraft type unknown. Crossing the border at Cape Landers, bearing 278 to 302. Captain Bartlett, your flight is the only group close enough to make the intercept.
Baker, sense it. Go trail and stay close. The three of us will go high and engage the bandits. All other aircraft stay low and out of the fight.
Down, and my stomach turned inside out.
Sorry about this.
The captain's apology to me seemed misplaced. One instructor had survived the fight, but crashed on landing. The other one was killed in action high up in the clouds. It wasn't his fault that the unidentified aircraft fired on us without warning. Nor was it his fault that the low-altitude area where he sent his trainees was directly in front of the enemy. 8 people died because the command room had misplaced some zeros. That pilot in the number 7 was amazing. Did you see her fight back?
I couldn't bear to watch. Nagase, you keep flying like that and you'll die real soon.
I won't die, sir.
The only surviving trainee's voice was almost a whisper.
Are you sure? You look like you couldn't hurt a fly.
Her face was pale, but she still managed to smile a bit for the camera. The photo, along with my camera, was confiscated by base security. It was as if our little undeclared war never happened. I came to cover this remote island because I heard that a very unique squadron leader was stationed here. I didn't realize he was this unique, though. This bad-mouthed, good-natured old firebrand could take the greenest of rookies and forge him into a fearsome fighter pilot. Of course, that possibility vanished with the day's encounter. The only crew he had left now were Second Lieutenant Nagase and the few pilots that happened to be on the ground that day.
I know you don't like this, but we're short on people. Starting tomorrow, all you Nuggets are gonna be sitting alert. If we launch, stay glued to me up there. Nagase?
Sir.
You're flying number 2 on my wing. Gotta keep an eye on you, or who knows what you'll get yourself into.
At ease, people. But don't get too comfortable. It's a grave situation for all of us right now. Let's get this briefing started.
Another aircraft of unknown origin has entered Ocean Federation airspace. We have confirmed the target type as a strategic recon plane flying at very high altitude. Despite our repeated warnings, it continued to penetrate our ADIS and was fired upon by Ocean Coastal Defense Force SAMs. We believe one of our SAMs damaged the unknown plane, but did not destroy it. Radar shows that the aircraft is currently losing altitude and is attempting to egress feet wet towards the ocean. Intercept this target and force it to land for identification. Do not fire upon this aircraft until further orders are transmitted.
Engage. hiding sucks, man. My senses are all numb. I don't even have time to be afraid.
Emergency transmission from Central.
The whole affair with the unidentified aircraft was covered up. There was even a rumor going around that it was actually a UFO. Officially, the world was still at peace. Having witnessed the battle myself, I wasn't allowed to leave the island.
Why do they even bother reprimanding me anymore? I know I'm gonna be stuck at Captain forever.
Who do you think's covering up the battle?
Listen. The only thing across that ocean is Murska Air Base. That's Yuktabanian territory.
But haven't we been allies with the Yuks since the war 15 years ago?
Yeah. That's why we got people working their asses off trying to confirm what the hell's going on over there. I bet they've got hotlines ringing off the hook somewhere upstairs. The government doesn't want to get the public riled up with all this, you know? But it doesn't matter. Soldiers like us are too stupid to think for ourselves, so we just gotta keep our mouths shut when they tell us to. I feel kinda bad for you, actually.
It's all right. I get to be with you guys.
Captain's probably hating this more than anybody.
Hmm?
He used to have a lady friend over in Yuktabania.
That's just an old war wound now.
A ship of unknown origin has been detected approaching the Sand Island coastline. We've confirmed that this ship has launched numerous unmanned aerial vehicles probably used for reconnaissance. The UAV will likely return to the launch ship for retrieval after completing their spy operations. You are to halt this operation by intercepting and destroying these recon drones before they can be recovered by the ship. However, do not attack the ship until further orders are transmitted.
This is Thunderhead. Unmanned recon drones returning to spy vessel. Shoot them down before they get back to the ship.
Sure thing. You got that, gang?
All right, let's go.
Our orders are to not fire on the ship, understood? Kid, calm down. Man, do I have to do everything for you? It just means I'm high-ranking officer material, Captain. Show me what you've got, kid. How you doing, kid? Pretty easy, huh? Okay, let's hurry up and finish this. I hate to be in a dogfight with these guys.
Are those drones removed?
so aim carefully.
Other recon crafts have probably reached the mainland too.
I sure hope not. I'm glad there aren't any live people in these things, aren't you? So we can just shoot them down and not worry about it. We better not get sloppy just because they're unmanned drones. Hey, kid, leave some enemies for me, okay?
Warning. Multiple bogeys inbound. Closing fast. Same attack axis as before. 280. Same vector as last time. Jeez, how many planes they got lined up?
Bounced us during the mission have been shot down. The country of origin of the ship is still unknown, but it has ceased operations in our maritime defense zone and has departed the area. Once we sanitize our coastal waters, we will conduct a search and rescue mission to find Captain Bartlett, who was shot down. Furthermore, the Union of Yuktobanian Republics has officially declared war on the Ocean Federation.
This was the room, or the cell, I had been assigned to. Captain Hamilton. Unlike his superior, the base commander who locked me in here, he's been very reasonable with me. He even got my camera back. He told me that if his uncle wasn't a soldier, he would have liked to have a job like mine.
Well, we don't have any reason to hold you anymore.
What do you mean?
Yuktobania just declared war. They've launched an offensive simultaneously, too. Our naval port at St. Hewlett is getting bombed right now.
There were only three of them now.
Our naval base at St. Hewlett reports that Yuktobanian aircraft have launched a surprise attack on the port. The situation there is critical, with widespread panic. Ships from the 3rd Ocean Naval Fleet docked at the port are currently under attack and taking heavy losses. Hurry to Port St. Hewlett and provide air cover for our naval vessels attempting to escape the bay. Among these ships is the aircraft carrier Kestrel. It is the flagship of the 3rd Naval Fleet and a critical combat asset. You must protect the Kestrel at all costs.
Thunderhead to Wardog. Edge, you lead the formation.
Negative. You take the lead, Blaze. I'll fly in your wing.
Second Lieutenant Nagase, follow your orders.
No, Blaze is leading. I'll protect at 6 o'clock. And I'm not gonna lose another flight lead.
Quit screwing around. This is war. The enemy's all over and they're gonna eat you alive.
I'd better stick to the trail position, thanks.
This is Captain Snow. Call sign Swordsman. Engaging next enemy formation. Give me a position.
This is the AA Cruiser Excalibur. The ship blocking us up ahead. You've got to move away. We can't use our spy radar.
Clear to engage.
Edge, engaging.
Chopper, engaging.
I'll cover your six. All right, please? You take the lead. I'll go trail and follow.
The tanker next to us just exploded! Where's the fireboat? It's spreading to our ship! Help us! Nobody saw them coming?
Their ships are just sitting at anchor. This is like target practice. Enemy reinforcements detected. Head up and get ready.
Captain, you don't have to give me the answer.
Cool! I'm ready for them anytime, so just say the word.
The fireboat got caught in the explosion! Ships are burning now!
This is not a drill.
Oh, thanks for the heads up, you idiot!
Your target is the enemy aircraft carrier and a large surface combatant surrounding it. Don't let them escape before you. Sink them all.
Protect the Kestrel at all costs!
It's time for our Aegis ship to live up to its name.
Thanks, everyone. We request your cover until we break out of port.
Blaze.
I shouldn't have looked. When that enemy plane crashed and covered the water in flames, there were people floating right there. I could see their faces. So many of them. Somebody stop this. I can't take it anymore.
Kid, did you see that? I see. Never mind then.
Missiles incoming from aft starboard. Two of them. We're out of the gulf, but stay alert.
The carrier's in the ocean. Come on. Whoever's out there, help us out. Get that bucket of bolts out of here.
This is the captain of the aircraft carrier Kestrel. My congratulations to all ships that managed to escape. As captain, I will now form a provisional battle fleet. The enemy's built a blockade with their fleet in front of us. We have to break through this and escape to safer waters. Good luck, everyone. All friendly aircraft, your support is requested.
Blaze, this is Thunderhead. Are you clear on the mission objective? Roger, begin the mission at once.
Range to blockade line confirmed at 4 miles.
Their formation centered around that carrier. Begin operations.
This is the perfect chance to improve our battle record. Let's go.
There's gotta be an enemy aircraft targeting the carrier from beyond the horizon. Stay on the lookout for inbound long-range anti-ship missiles.
Kestrel, looks like this is it for us. Hope you make it out safely.
But the captain, Captain Bartlett, never returned to Sand Island.
The aircraft carrier Kestrel has survived the enemy attack and has broken through into open waters. Although the 3rd Ocean Naval Fleet sustained considerable damage, it's still combat capable.
When the rescue chopper arrived, the captain was nowhere to be seen. The only thing they found was the retreating enemy intelligence vessel. This island used to be a place of exile from the rest of the world. It then became our first line of defense against the enemy.
Who'll be the flight lead tomorrow? I wouldn't waste my energy worrying about that if I were you. We're We're an auxiliary squadron, you know. So His Highness, the Lieutenant Colonel, will just come down from the mainland and take over. That's all. Phew. I love this sound. Calms me down. I'm gonna sleep well tonight.
I heard that the one who broke the captain's heart 15 years ago was a recon major in the Uke Army.
Yeah, I did my history homework. We were allies back then. Man, the base commander sure wasn't being subtle about making accusations.
Was there anything suspicious about the captain's behavior, he says.
Hell, I'm more suspicious about the screw in his damn head.
Ah, you're kidding me. An air raid? Give me a break, man.